Joining us right now is Maharashtra DGP, Mr. Subodh Jaiswal. Mr. Jaiswal, thank you very much for speaking to Republic Media Network. Let me straight away begin by asking you, how exactly is Maharashtra responding to the national lockdown call that has been given by the Prime Minister also? Mr. Jaiswal, if you can hear me, I would like to begin by asking you, how exactly is Maharashtra responding to the national lockdown?
Thank you very much for having me on your program. At the outset, let me tell you that the administration has been on the job and working extremely effectively in trying to enforce the lockdown in a most humane manner, ensuring that all essential services supplies are maintained and are in place. The police force is doing an extremely commendable job. Our police personnel are all across 45 units of the state have been doing very, very well and taking all responsibility and ownership for enforcing the actions that we have been called upon to do.
Mr. Jaiswal, there are certain concerns, especially as far as movement is concerned, be it the essential services or for that matter even farm produce, agricultural produce that is being brought in. How exactly are you going to tackle that sort of a movement at this point in time?
At the outset, let me tell you that very clear instructions have been given to all units of Maharashtra Police down the line to the last man constable on the street. And we have given very clear instructions and guidelines that there shall be unhindered movement of essential commodities and services to all concerned. And this includes movement of trucks and other vehicles which are involved with movement of goods and services relating to supply of essential commodities and all. And we have also set up helplines in all the districts. We have also activated our Twitter handles, and we are totally on the job to take on any challenges that are being faced by the organizations which are handling these services. We have since the last 5 days, we have received about 50,000 calls in Mumbai and about 20,000 calls in the rest of Maharashtra on our helplines in the state across the districts. And we are addressing all the challenges which are being put to us. We have also got in touch with the various e-commerce companies, and we are trying to address all their challenges, whether it is by way of providing passes for the vehicles or providing access to various godowns and things like that. Our unit commanders and their subordinate staff officers are all totally on the job, and we hope to do a good job of enforcing this lockdown.
Mr. Jaiswal, before this interview, we had basically put out this information that you would be joining us, and there are certain queries that we would like to now take. These queries are by residents of Maharashtra. So I'll begin by the first question that they are asking you, is that are there timings set for grocery milk stores in Mumbai?
No, there are no timings set for groceries. In fact, we are making efforts that all shops and establishments which are supplying these items remain open 24 hours. These have been instructions given by the government, and we are making all efforts to ensure this is being done primarily to ensure that no crowding takes place at a particular point in time during the day.
Mr. Jaiswal, let me move to the second question posed by K. Raj. He's asking that can there be buses that could be arranged for people who are stranded and want to go to their native places? And I would just like to elaborate on that point, because we've also seen multiple reports for coming in, not just from the national capital, but also from Maharashtra, where people want to go back to their native places. So is there anything that could be done for the movement of those people who've got stranded?
I'm sorry to state very, very categorically and clearly that no movement on the roads will be allowed for such people. The government has given now very clear instructions saying that suitable arrangements for lodging and boarding of these people who are moving on the highways or are stranded at some places will be made by the district administration, and our police units are moving along with the district administration to do the needful.
This question, Mr. Jaiswal, is from Bhandari Dwij, who is asking, how does the police differentiate between those who are going out for groceries and those who are essentially loitering around?
The police is depending upon the goodwill of the individual concerned, because it's a more of a voluntary effort also on part of the public, and we are appealing to their good sense to listen to the advisories given by the government from time to time, and we are appealing to the public to remain inside the houses so as to not to create a situation which may not be good for the society at large. I would also like to point out that there are enough provisions of law to handle such recalcitrant behavior, but at the same time I would like to state very clearly and humbly and appeal to the people that please stay home if you are not required to move out.
Mr. Jaiswal, the next question is with regards to, should apartment management committees stop morning walk in the compound even if residents are maintaining social distancing? Also, we have seen several morning walkers in iconic places like Marine Drive, for that matter, even other places. So is there any sort of message that you would like to send across to all those people who are still stepping out in the morning for their normal exercise?
Thank you very much for this question. In fact, this is what we have been seeing, and I would like to appeal to all such people that the prohibitory orders state very clearly that residents shall stay at home and come out only for permitted activities. My appeal to all such people is kindly do not stretch the prohibitory orders, which will make it difficult for the enforcement authorities, and ultimately it is their lives also which are at stake. So we must try and adhere by the letter of the law in such matters, and I request all such individuals to abide by the legal position.
Mr. Jaiswal, this is a very important case, if I may say.
Yes.
Sorry,
yes, Mr. Jaiswal, more questions coming in because there are people who want to avail. Coming to you, Shavan, just a bit. More questions when there are people who want to avail medical facilities and they are wanting to go to hospitals there. So, Sazda, you have cancer patients. Cancer patients are saying that they have the set dates for chemotherapy, but they are being stopped by the police, and their family members also who are accompanying them, but they are being stopped. How would you answer and would want to respond to that?
Thank you very much for the question. It's a very good question. Ma'am, let me make it very, very clear that our 100 number helpline has been working 24/7. Any such challenge faced by any individual, kindly connect, call 100, and we shall provide whatever assistance that is required, including transportation also, by arranging a facility like that and making sure that no such challenge is faced by people who are facing such conditions.
Mr. Jaiswal, the next question is from Rahul, who's basically asking this, that in the situation of a lockdown, we have seen streets deserted. What happens to the beggars as well as street dwellers? And I'd just like to have a supplemental question on this, because this is with regards to these slum areas. What there are people wanting to know, is there enough that is being done to spread awareness in slums? Because there have been concerns with regard to proximity and the number of people who live together. What kind of awareness is being done, especially in slum areas?
I can answer this by simply saying that a lot of information has been shared by the media, by the NGOs, and most importantly by the government through its agencies, informing the people about the challenges that we are facing. This is something which is unprecedented and something which we had not even thought through or calibrated. We had never faced a situation like this, and enough information is now in public space, and it is ultimately up to the people to ensure that they take all necessary precautions.
All right, Mr. Jaiswal, we are also taking callers, and you will hear them taking your questions as well. They would want to hear from you directly. Dr. S.K. Bridger is also joining us from Mumbai. Sir, good afternoon. Your question, please.
S.K. Bridger here, sir. I am from Faridabad.
Yep.
Yes, please.
Yeah, please carry on.
Yeah, I am from Faridabad, sir, and my son stays in Mumbai. When I see the visuals on TV, I am very much concerned that the people are taking their vehicles and moving in here and there in Mumbai. They can go to the neighborhood shops for...
Sorry, it's not coming through.
Yeah. And they can go to the neighborhood shops or buying their groceries. Why they have to take their vehicles? It is creating a lot of, I think, concern in my mind also. So how can you restrict the movement of vehicles?
It's a very, very, it's a very, very valid question, and we are trying to do it through enforcement, and we are trying to appeal to the people and to use their good judgment in the matter and try and avoid movement of through vehicles. We have seen some movement of vehicles, but at the moment we are trying to enforce it as properly as possible without causing any undue challenge to any individual.
Mr. Jaiswal, another question that is coming in on Twitter. This is with regards to, I picked up my sister from Mumbai before the lockdown. She works with Amazon Mumbai, and as it's allowed now as essentials, she's got the pass. But how can I drop her back to her place in Mumbai and come back to Pune in my car without restrictions imposed by police? So what I do understand is that if there is any sort of travel that is being allowed from because of essential services, would it be possible that someone goes back to Pune after dropping her sister by car to Mumbai?
No, I'm sorry. That kind of movement on inter-district movement has been banned totally, excepting for a very essential service. In this case, I would request the individual to contact 100 Pune and see what can be done. But inter-district movement of personnel, of public, has been stopped totally.
All right, sir. Another caller that we have joining us here on the broadcast, Lieutenant Colonel Jyotsna Savle, joining us from Satara. Yes, please, your question.
Good afternoon, DGP. This is Jyotsna here. Two things I wanted to convey to you. Number one, the movements in Mumbai are not satisfactory in comparison even to UP. And number two, many videos I have seen where the police has been beaten up by the people, which is not acceptable. I will not accept it. Police is doing an extraordinary job. They should be respecting police, not hitting them. Kindly take action against them.
Thank you, ma'am. We'll do the needful. Just for information, we have registered about 3,000 cases for violation of prohibitory orders across the state since last 5 days. And we are not likely to take anything lying down in case of an attack on a police personnel.
Mr. Jaiswal, with regards to some directives that also came in from the Ministry of Home Affairs with regards to discrimination that we saw in the national capital, especially against doctors and even for that matter, airline staff. Are you also getting similar sort of reports in Maharashtra? If so, what sort of action that is being taken? And would you also like to reassure all the doctors as well as airline staff that they need not worry? Is there anything that you would like to convey to all the doctors as well as airline staff in Maharashtra?
Let me tell you very, very clearly, since the day the lockdown has started, we have given extremely clear-cut directions to all our policemen and police personnel that doctors, paramedical staff, nurses have to be given the utmost of respect while handling, while letting them move in the city. It is, the guidance is very, very clear. No action, no untoward behavior should be done towards such fellow professionals who have been doing an outstanding service. And are, we have also reached out to all the doctors and their associations, pointing out to them, in case any such thing happens, please get in touch, call 100, call the helplines, so that we take immediate correctives without fear or favor.
All right, Mr. Jaiswal, thank you very much, sir. Maharashtra DGP joining us, and for your time and taking up all those questions, though they are still lining up, as also callers are continuously calling in. We're just running out of time here, but thank you very much, sir, for giving us your time and answering all of those questions.